Another video because I neglected to a lot of you guys have been asking me how I've been making, you know, so I make $7,000 to $10,000 a month, $7,000 to $9,000 roughly, okay, roughly. Some months I hit 10, but you know, it fluctuates. It just depends on what's happening with the public. But a lot of you have been asking me how have I been able to you know, get so many referrals and have so many people, you know, join without, you know, without buying any traffic or anything like that. And, you know, I've explained to you guys that, you know, when you give people sufficient information, you know, they're able to, other people are able to use that information and make a determination of whether they want to join your opportunity or not. But I neglected to tell you guys something that was extremely valid, and I apologize about that. I created a marketing guide called Neuro Linguistic Marketing, okay? And basically what this marketing guide is it teaches people how to, it teaches people how to use hypnotic ad marketing, you know, Disney, Verizon, all of the huge, super duper duper, corporations that does public promotion, you know, especially Disney. These people use a whole bunch of hypnotic ad marketing, and the techniques and how to do this is, it's kind of like neuro-linguistic marketing, but it's a little different. And I forgot that I actually wrote a guide explaining to you guys how to do this. Now, you're going to see a video, a short clip of one of the Will Smith a movie that Will Smith made, and I want you to watch the technique. And once you watch the technique, I'm going to show you how to implement this technique while marketing and utilizing your ads. This is a very, very, very extremely powerful tool. And also, I ask you guys not to use this tool to hurt or harm anybody, because you can use this to control people. And I just want you guys to respect this information that you're about to learn. I want you to just check this new video clip that's coming out right now.
How did you know who he was gonna pick?
We told him to. I've been telling him all day. From the moment he left his hotel room, we've been priming him, programming his subconscious. He's been seeing the number 55 all day long. On the elevator, in the lobby, even the stick pin on the doormat. Not only that, we loaded his route from the hotel to the stadium. He looks out the window, primers are everywhere. Now he doesn't see it, but he does. There's no getting around it. He even sees Farhad. Suggestions are everywhere, from the number of flowers in a vase to the tramp stamp on the hooker we sent to his room last night.
That is genius.
Yeah, and it's not only what he sees, it's what he hears. The Mandarin word for five is Wu. There are 124 woo-woos in Sympathy for the Devil. Now, he's not registering it, but it's all there. So when he picks up those binoculars, looks out on the field, sees a familiar face with the number 55 on his jersey, some little voice in the back of his mind says, that's it. And he thinks it's intuition, and he picks.
Do you want me to write it down?
And you, being in the dark, was the convincer. We call that the little blind mouse.
All right, guys, now that you've seen the Will Smith clip, I want you guys to understand that this is a real technique. It's not just something for the movies or whatever. Like, this is real, you know, and I use it all the time, and I'm going to show you how I use it in my website. I want you to take a look at my website. I'm going to point out a couple of things to you, and then I'll be right back. Welcome, guys. Okay, this is a part of this video. I've stopped the other recordings to show you some of the techniques that I was getting ready to talk to you about in neuro-linguistic marketing. And basically, I want to show you how I implemented them myself on the on my page. If you notice, if you're looking at this, I put this here. I chose this picture because it reminds you of a path that goes upwards or whatever. Just a path. A clear path, okay? Your mind may not pick up on this, but your subconscious will.
Down here, if you notice, there's some little figures there holding hands or whatever, and they're joined together or whatever. So your mind perceives pictures. Your mind's looking at pictures or whatever, and your subconscious turn those pictures into a thing or a substance that your mind can understand. And this right here is this just gives your subconscious joining type of a command in there. Okay, so as you start to move on or whatever, here's a warm cup of tea. Again, something this picture, the warmth of this picture, you know, represents just people, comfortability. You know, people are comfortable when they're warm or whatever. So this is why this is there. If you scroll down, okay, there's another little picture here that says join today. Okay, it says join today, and it's very small or whatever, but the subconscious mind picks it up. If you scroll down a little bit further, you're going to see something that's an eye. There's an eye right there, okay? And also there's an eye right here. Eye, okay? And then you scroll down, will here, and there's a join here. Join now right here. There's a little puzzle clip that says join now. And then it says it's fine. It's fine right here. It's fine. And that's it's fine is another embedded command, okay? Just letting you know it's fine to join. Okay, so I will, and if you scroll down, join here. And the thing is, people aren't even noticing this. Look at these arms joined together. These arms joined together here. It says join again down here. And basically, you know, as you scroll down the page or whatever, these embedded commands, you're not paying attention to them. When people come to this page or whatever, they're usually looking at my PayPal payment or whatever, or proof. Then they scroll down and they look at the videos or whatever, then they scroll down to join. They don't really pay attention to all of these embedded commands on the side of the page or whatever, but they're here. They're here and they work. Your subconscious is way more, it picks up on way more things. Your mind filters out things that it does not need. It only focuses on a small percentage of things that it needs at the particular time. So whatever you're focusing on, that's what your mind is focusing on. But your mind as a whole doesn't discard the information just because it's not picking it up. You know, it just because it's being filtered doesn't mean it's being discarded. So your mind picks up on all of this. So your subconscious is seeing everything on this page or whatever that your conscious is not really perceiving. And this is what this video was about. And I will hopefully you guys will get this neuro-linguistic marketing guide, because it's a great guide. And you guys take care and check out the next part of the video.
Okay, guys, now that you've seen these suggestions that are on my website, I hope you've gotten a clear understanding of just how using the power of suggestion will help you in marketing or whatever. You know, a lot of times people, they've already have a preconceived notion that what you're doing is a scam, or you're out to get them, because there's so many scammers online that people just don't know. So they've just been preconditioned over time and incident that allows them to, you know, forces them to believe that everybody's out to get them and everybody's out to scam them. So when you have people coming to your offer or your business with that mindset, you know, it's your job to basically get them out of that mindset so that you can actually do good business with them and get them at ease and let them know that, you know, you're not trying to scam them. So these techniques are to help and aid in that situation.
You are freezing. Yeah. I'm sorry, it's cold out there. Thank you for coming at 7:45 in the morning to Hamley's. There is your goodie bag.
Thank you.
Don't eat them all now, you make yourself sick. There's 5 floors, so we're going to have a walk right up the top and stop over at various spots on the way. Just want you to get a sense of the store, and because I haven't really told you what we're going to do at all, have I?
No,
you
have no idea. Not clear.
Lovely. Let's just have a little walk around first so you're familiar with the layout. Do you have a favourite toy when you were little?
I quite like Barbies, I suppose.
So this is soft toys. Let's head up here. Let's go for a wander around. Chess, get your photo taken. This is your games. We go up another one. More toys. Did you have any books when you were little?
Yeah, I loved reading.
It's amazing how much you absorb unconsciously, even just looking at these now when you're little. How much sticks in the mind without even being aware of it. Let's keep going. frightening dolls.
Oh, yeah.
Doll's house.
I remember I had a big dolphin that I used to play with quite a lot.
Oh, so you like cuddly toys too, huh?
Yeah.
Certainly had a lot of those.
Boys' toys, really.
Up to the top. Okay. So that is all five or so floors of families.
Okay.
Now you've had a chance just to kind of get a basic sense of the layout of the store, I'm going to ask you to now go on a bit of a wander.
Okay.
Back down through the levels of the shop yourself and to select a toy, but only sort of mentally select a toy. Very important you don't give away what this toy is. So we're not going to follow you with the cameras.
Okay.
But imagine that you were being followed and you wouldn't want to give away to anybody what it was. So you don't need to pick this toy up. All you need to do is mentally go, okay, that one, and take your goodie bag and have a wander around. See you in a bit.
See ya.
Okay, you've had a wander?
Yeah.
Chosen something? Found something?
Yeah.
First of all, you haven't told anybody what it is. No one's asked you?
No.
No one's filming you?
No.
In your mind, be very clear what it is, be very clear where it is, and I'll be asking you all sorts of questions, but unless I say answer out loud, don't answer out loud. You're just answering in your head. Actually, if we can start going down, it wouldn't be up here, because we didn't really get a look up here, so. So let's go down to this floor here. Yeah, this is sort of quite boys' stuff up here. This is definitely the boys' floor. And as you think about this, can you imagine, so don't answer out loud, but in your mind, is there somebody, if you were going to give this toy as a gift to somebody, just in your mind, imagine giving it to this person, how they look at me. Yeah, I think it's a girl's thing. Let's go down. I think this is a girl. It's a girl in your mind, isn't it? You're going to give it to, yeah. Give nothing away, just answer in your head. Your friend's name, though, as you were saying it in your mind, nothing out loud, just certainly in your mind, it's got a V. Vicky, is it Vicky?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Let's just clear all those out of your head so you can just keep focusing on this toy. Imagine giving it to Vicky. So you're going here. I got it. It's over here. Okay, come back over here. Okay, just start to think warmer, colder in your head. Warmer, colder, warmer, colder. So you're telling me where to go. You're saying nothing out loud, but you're telling me warmer, colder, warmer, hotter, hotter, colder, okay, colder, cold. This is colder, isn't it? And then warmer's over here. I think she's more cats than dogs, but a dog, chimp, giraffe, say nothing. I think it's one of these three. Okay, you look at that one first, it won't be that. Present you're going to give Vicky. I think by the fact you're trying not to move your eyes over there, I think, am I right, and I'm going to commit to this, there are 250,000 toys in this store. I think the present you were going to give Vicky is the giraffe, am I right?
Yeah.
Yes, oh, thank you so much. God, well, there you go, and give that to Vicky with my compliments. It's, wow. Incidentally, if you were going to give that a name, what would you call it?
Frank?
Yeah. That's a good name for giraffe, it's not too obvious. Well, enjoy that. Oh, by the way, in your goodie bag, you've had this on you all the time, haven't you?
Yeah.
By the way, if you see the tissue, there's a few sweets with that tissue paper. If you open it up, there's a little extra thing when you give this to Vicky. I thought it'd be quite a nice touch just to, a little name collar. Just a giraffe. And just show the camera there so they can see it. It just ties around the neck. I thought it'd be a quite sweet little present.
Oh, my God.
Oh, can we just show the camera again? You didn't quite get that. You got it? Excellent. And while you're here...
Oh my God.
Yeah, good luck getting in the car.
How do you do that?
Did it feel like a free choice?
Yeah, completely. Yeah? I didn't even decide on Frank first. That was like, I went for a few names.
You did, yeah, you were changing your mind. You've been amazing.
Oh,
thank you
so much. Thank
you. You're absolutely brilliant.
Thank
Have a lovely
so
day.
Much.
I'll let you chat
you
to the
too. Oh, thanks. Oh, it's really like overwhelming. Like, I have no idea like how he would know that before I even sort of came up with it. It like, felt like such a free choice. Quite surreal, but really exciting. Really fun.
And Alice is here with us at the moment. Round of applause for Alice. A few of you clearly were getting a giraffe as well. Do you know why you were thinking of giraffe too? Would you believe me if I told you that I actually mined a giraffe as soon as you came in through the doors? Oh, you picked up on it. I'll show you a couple of the things that we did.
We're going to have a walk right up to the top and stop over at various spots on the way.
Various spots on the way. See it again? So we're gonna have a walk right up to the top and stop over at various spots on the way. And then as we went in, I actually said giraffe right too. I don't know if you caught this, so you have to listen carefully, but keep going. Do you have a favourite toy when you were little? And again? Do you have a favourite toy when you were little? I don't know where the northern accent came from, that's giraffe, yeah? And there were loads of other subliminals throughout the store. A giraffe face printed on these t-shirts. With UV light, you can now see the word giraffe on the books we looked at. We place pictures of giraffes on the escalators and on the walls, and giraffe print patterns all around the store too. We even had letters spelling the word giraffe hanging from the ceiling. So with all these subliminal messages, when Alice went off to make her selection, I was confident she would choose a giraffe. Thank you, Alice, well done. And that's perception without awareness, and this is just the start.
So you've just seen the techniques from Darren Brown, and basically what he was doing was he was just basically suggesting things to that woman throughout the course of time. She was you know, being anchored, and she was being hit with the power of suggestion, and those two things combined or whatever is why she chose the giraffe. And I want you guys to understand that this book is extremely powerful. Like I said, please don't use this to control your girlfriend or to control people, to get people to do things for you. I mean, that's real fucked up if you do something like that. Excuse my language, but it is. So I mean, like, it's good enough that you're using the information to use in business, but don't take advantage of people. You know what I mean? Next, the end video that I want you to see. The video basically explains to you how to use this technique in a conversational text or whatever. The guy is going to be basically speaking, and then he's going to explain to you what he just done to you while speaking or whatever, and he's going to break down how these should suggest these suggestive statements can actually trigger the subconscious into doing things, or trigger the subconscious into viewing things in a certain way, in a certain manner. And after you guys view this or whatever, I want you to take a look in the description section, or if you're on Facebook or whatever, look up or whatever. There's going to be a link there to this book. It's called Neuro-Linguistic Marketing. It's a really, really dope book. It's a really good book for you guys to have. You're going to learn a lot. You're going to learn a lot from this book. And it's very, it's not even expensive. It's like under $10. So get the book. You're going to need this in marketing. You're going to need this type of information in marketing. It's very important that you have it, and it's going to change your whole marketing world. You know, people have to understand that you're mixing your suggestive thought, and kind of you're mixing the spiritual world with the marketing world. You know, your brain and the way you think and your thought patterns have a large part to do with, you know, the success in your business and how you interact with people. And you know, you can't separate the two. People are dealing with a human being and a soul, and you have to learn how to connect with that soul on that particular, you know, on that level of business, you know, because there is a human interaction going on. So you have to learn how to utilize that as well. And in this book, you're going to learn a powerful tool that's going to drive your marketing out of the roof, and I give you my word that these techniques are very powerful and they work. So check out this video clip or whatever. Hope to talk to you guys soon, and I hope you get my product.
In this video, I'm going to teach you what embedded commands are, how they work, and how to use them. Now, before we begin, you may be familiar with the concepts of your unconscious mind. Perhaps you've heard things like, it's always listening, taking care of everything that is important for you to go about living your life happily, healthily, and so forth. From breathing to digestion, from dreaming to sleeping, your unconscious mind takes care of millions of processes every day. While your conscious mind is right here, listening to me, and it's totally aware of everything that I'm saying. When you have a conversation with yourself, that's your conscious mind at work. Kinda cool, isn't it? But here's the thing. There's no such thing as an unconscious mind or a conscious mind.
What?
You heard that right. These are descriptions. They are not empirical, but we use the words of conscious and unconscious to describe various processes at work. So what exactly is an embedded command then? An embedded command is a form of covert suggestion that, as its name suggests, is embedded within a larger communication or content. In fact, there were several examples in the introduction to this video I just gave you, but more on that in a moment. For now, the first thing, if you want to get good with embedded commands, it's easy. Remember, there isn't some place you're trying to lodge a suggestion. Rather, you're looking to present your suggestions in a covert or non-overt way, so a person's conscious mind doesn't screw things up. Sometimes it's better to be overt in your communication and just come right out and say it. And other times it can be more useful to be subtle. So in the introduction to this video, I use several embedded commands, such as embedded commands. Use them now. Your unconscious is always listening. Living your life healthily, happily, dreaming to sleeping, your unconscious is at work. And then just a moment ago, I said, get good with embedded commands, it's easy. So you see, even in this very tight communication, it's possible to pack several embedded commands in. Here's the process on how you do this. One, figure out what is it you want to say or prime in another person's mind. Write it out. It could be something like, you're going to enjoy this course, or learning can happen quickly. Next, two, figure out what kind of wrapper you're going to use to deliver the embedded commands. In this case, I created the context of an introduction and talking about two concepts within which I embedded my suggestions. Three, choose your method for marking out the commands or suggestions. There are lots of ways to do this. I chose to change my tempo and reduce my tone when I was marking out suggestions for your unconscious mind to pick up on. Four, if this is your first time using embedded commands, practice delivering the suggestions within your wrapper story with friends and others who are not going to really give a hoot or care if you
fire. Five,
once you've got it down, use it for real, in real context, in terms of intended context that you want to get the outcome, and notice how you get on. There are many other ways that you can mark out embedded commands. You can, for example, put a pause right before the command that you intend to deliver. As I mentioned, you can change tone. You can make a non-verbal anchor, like moving your hand. Now, obviously that's quite obvious, but you can do it in more discreet ways. You can look in one person's eye, a particular eye, consistently when you deliver a message. As I say, there are many ways, but for now I want you to just focus on the one that I've given you, which is changing your tempo and slightly reducing your voice tone in a downward inflection. Oh, and by the way, one last thing. I know you're probably going to ask this, so I'll answer it now. How many times do you need to embed a suggestion in order for it to work? That's a fair question. And remember, two things. One, there isn't a somewhere deep you are looking to stick anything. What you're looking to do is impart a pattern of thoughts and suggestions on your listener. For some people, they may pick it up in 3 and 4 suggestions. For others, it may take 10 or 12. It will vary. One of the most famous hypnotists ever, Milton Erickson, once said he wasn't concerned with how many times he had to say it. Was it 1, 2, or 3 times that he would embed a suggestion? Rather, he would say it in multiple forms and multiple ways until he got the result that he wanted. So it's going to vary from person to person. And lastly, I know you're probably going to ask, how do I know when they've got it? And this is a really good question. A lot of people just basically give you fluff answers. How are you going to know? Because you will see a change in their behavior, in their thoughts, in their feelings, in their action. So whatever it is, if you were, for example, having them enjoy the training or that they were going to learn quickly and easily, you would see some behavioral outcomes that would indicate that. Okay, that's it for now. If you want to learn more about neurolinguistic programming, NLP, then please check out the link below.